So I grew up in a small town called Karbala. It's to the southeast of Baghdad. And I was supposed to be a teacher, teaching Iraqi kids how to speak English as a second language. But an opportunity presented itself for me to be a part of the OIF, Operation Iraqi Freedom, which is to be an interpreter, linguist, and cultural advisor for the U.S. Army. 2013, things were just terrible. Everybody was a target. You don't know when is your day is coming. Opening my door every morning, I can't even normally open my door where I used to live in Iraq. I had to go from my fence, and we have like brick fence, high ones. I had to jump, make sure there's not a grenade attached to my door when I open it. Like these kind of things, and you don't know who would attack you. It's a jungle. Didn't get any better. It just got worse and worse. And that's when I talked to some of my friends here in the U.S. and they were like, you should apply for an immigration, like a visa, to come over here. You cannot just stay there. So I did, and I applied, and I went through the process, and I was immigrated here to the U.S. in 2014, and I've been here since. It was the hardest decision that I have to make. Like, sometimes people can't agree where to go for dinner. And now you're just talking about moving an entire family. I left my house, I left my mom, I left four sisters, two brothers. We're family oriented, a lot of, like, we're big on like family and getting together and seeing, like. So it was hard to make that decision. But then it's either taking that risk or stay there and die. So we had to take the risk, and it was the best decision I have ever made. I remember a situation that happened with me and my wife at the airport at JFK, that we were there and I had eight bags for my family. So I brought four and I came back for the other four, and I saw these two senior citizens sitting at the airport talking to my wife. And I was approaching. I was scared to death. I didn't know what they were saying to her. I didn't know what they're, because she has the headgear. But when I approached, they were simply just, hey, I like that on your head. What is it called? What is it made of? I wish we have time. You can teach me how to wrap it over my head. That was the lady. You know, your kids are so lovely and cute. And that just, like, put me at ease. And I told my wife, we're gonna be fine here. We're happy, we're safe. We just purchased our house, and now I'm a homeowner, as scary as it is. My wife goes to school, she's gonna be a teacher assistant next year. We'll graduate from MCC. I work at a good company, and I make a good living to provide for my family. We pay our bills. I think one of my goals also to give back. I mean, that's why we do some volunteer stuff. We try our best, because those people who helped us when we got here, most of them were volunteers. And I believe it's now on us to continue that. So, yeah, we're happy and safe now, and that's all what it matters.